Good morning.
Good morning, internet.
Happy Vlogmas day 9. So I woke up to a phone call around 4:15 a.m. So before my before I had set my alarm to go off. And it was from CVS saying, we see that you have a booster shot scheduled for 5 a.m. No one's here at that time to do that shot. Which, you know, that makes sense. Yeah. I thought it was weird.
I was wondering why they had 5 a.m., 1 a.m.
They had like 1 a.m., 2 a.m., like all these appointments available. But there's no one there. He's like, we don't open till 6:30. So you can walk in anytime and we'll just process you in as a walk-in. So I went back to sleep and we woke up. Yeah. We just finished cycle.
And it's raining in San Diego. Every once in a while, a little rain must fall, yep. Even in San Diego.
You see, it's all wet.
Gross.
It's rainy. So anyway, I am still gonna get my booster. We're gonna go right now because I feel like if I don't go today, I'm just gonna keep putting it off.
And I have a 9:30 call or 9 a.m. call, so I need to be Audi 5000 by 8:30.
Okay, yeah, 8:30. So it's like 8. Pretty
we've
much.
Got a minute. We're okay.
Okay, all right. So anyway, yeah, we're gonna drive to CVS. We were gonna walk, but we are on a time crunch.
And it's raining.
And it's rainy. It's just kind of like, it's not too cold. It's just damp.
Yeah.
It's damp and like a little burr.
It's
just a little
burr. This actually reminds me of kind of rain in the south.
Really?
Yeah. You know, it's not a cold rain, not a warm rain. It's just, it's humid out.
Yeah. All right. I'm going to have Tyler film my injection.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah. Okay.
What are we doing here? But I was reading Omicron actually, Pfizer works best against Omicron, but Moderna works best against Delta.
Okay. I think Delta is worse than Omicron.
Yes. Eventually we're all going to need an Omicron booster too. We're gonna have enough.
Why did they go from Delta to Omicron?
That's a good question.
Alpha.
You think it would have been
Alpha, Beta,
Gamma.
Delta, Epsilon.
No,
Delta, Epsilon.
Yeah. There was already an Epsilon variant.
Theta, Eta. I can't belong to Mu, Nu, Xi, Omicron, Pyro, Sigma, Tau, Epsilon. What? I said Epsilon twice.
Yeah. Phi, why did you learn the Greek alphabet?
Omega. Now I know the Greek alphabet. But I don't know because I forgot some of them.
Like you go to UC Santa Barbara and you're like, you have to learn all the Greek letters so you can go drinking.
I can't remember when I had to learn the Greek alphabet. I think it was middle school. Maybe we were learning about the Greeks.
All right, here is your updated vaccine card.
Thank you.
And you had no questions, correct?
No.
All right, we do ask you to stay inside the store for 10 minutes after it is self-monitoring. You can walk around or have a seat out there. When the time's up, you don't have to let us know. You can just go if you're feeling all right.
Cool. Thank you.
Ever tell you why I have zero fear of needles?
Why?
Neither does Cecily, actually.
Oh, no, because you had to get so many shots for something.
Yeah.
Because you were, like, dying or something.
No, Tom was dying. We were exposed to tuberculosis.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
So we had weekly blood draws for 2 years, I think it was.
Yeah. That'll get you used to needles.
Yeah.
And then I am finally ready.
Do you
want
to slide closer to you?
No, I can just take a step over if that's all right with you.
Do you want me to hold your hand?
No, it's just.
Do you want me to distract you by saying something funny?
It's just uncomfortable.
It's just a little prick.
It's just a little prick, mental pressure. And that was it. Oh my god,
it. You're not bleeding or anything. Still gonna throw a bandaid on you real quick.
I feel like that was easier than the originals.
You are all set, okay?
Great, thank you.
Just a
oh my god.
Let's walk around store for 10 minutes.
Walk around store for 10 minutes.
Look, makeup store.
So this could, imagine if this were your highlighter.
Uh-huh.
you'd be just glowing.
I would be glowing.
You'd be able to see yourself from space.
Ooh, liquid eyeliner, that's good stuff. Oh God, my arm.
Your poor arm.
I'm just destroyed. I'm falling apart.
Hello. I am back home. Tyler is on his way to his place. I've been boosted, as you saw. And I kind of got a little bit of a chill morning. This is kind of nice. I feel like the past 3 days have been go, go, go. Even, I mean, the past four days have been very go, 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 because Sunday was Tyler's birthday and it was like cycle, get him ready, go to the show, like all this stuff. Monday was super busy. Tuesday was super busy. Yesterday was super busy. And so now I don't have anything until, oh golly. So my wax is either at 10 or 10:30. It's currently 8:30. Let's just check my calendar. 10:30, great. Oh, so I had put in my calendar to starting right now to work from home. I don't want to. I want to relax. I want to relax. I can do work from home when I get home this evening. I might do some. I don't know. I don't know about you, but I don't like to get started on a project or a task that's going to take a long period of time where I need to have a lot of focus and not be interrupted or not feel like I have to be somewhere. And I think if I start doing some of these tasks for work now, I don't know. I just worry that I might lose track of time and I want to eat breakfast. I'm hungry. Yeah. And maybe even like hop in the shower for a quick body bath, body wash. Anyway, that was a little journey. So I'm just going to delete that from my calendar because, or I'll move it. I'll move it later. I'll do it. I'll move it to later and I will move it later. And because right now I'm talking to you. Okay, I do want more coffee. I've just had one cup. So I'm going to do that. Let me set you down. Okay, get more coffee and I am going to make breakfast. I want eggs. I want eggs. I need the protein. It just sounds really filling and satisfying. So that is what I will do. I don't know what these accents are. I don't know if it's problematic if I do accents like that. It just like feels good in my mouth. I don't know. But they're not accurate, and so it's not respectful to the individuals or the populations who actually speak in something of that dialect. I don't know. So I took a diversity class in the fall semester, so that ended, and it just has made me really aware of certain things, like, am I being racist? Am I being homophobic or transphobic? Or am I making certain comments that I didn't realize were offensive? And so it's just, it brings up that second thought of after I do something, I now have this sort of filter of even if I say something, I kind of like will catch it and be like, oh, was that okay or not okay? I don't know. Same kind of thing with last night where Tyler was saying like crazed hobos. I'm like, I don't like that. I'm not comfortable with that. They're people. And a lot of the time, yes, they struggle with mental illness, but when you call them crazed hobos, you're taking away their personhood. Like you're objectifying them in a way and turning them into a stereotype. And it's just really damaging. I don't know. Okay, wow. I didn't expect to go down that path. So I'm gonna make breakfast. I have my coffee here. I'm still using my little ghost mug that I got for myself for the fall. I was actually just telling Tyler, I really wanted to get myself a
something kind of Christmassy and festive, a mug like that for this season as well. But I'm a very, very truly broke graduate student. Really and truly, I have to check myself with these little cravings, like these purchase cravings that I get. Not that I've ever, for a long time, ever since I discovered minimalism, I have not been like a shopper the way I used to be. So that's good. It trained me very well for being a very broke grad student. However, I would still get these little purchase cravings and just kind of, you know, because it was few and far between, I would let myself buy certain things. And now I have to think, go that extra step of, is this something I really need? And not just because I'm a minimalist and don't want a lot of extra things, but it's, can I afford this? Can I really afford it? Technically, I can afford nothing. Technically. So I have to prioritize the essentials, and a Christmas mug is not an essential. So, and that's okay. And then it's also not, it's acknowledging that yes, I would like that and it would bring me joy to use it in the mornings during this time of year, but I can still enjoy this time of year without a Christmas mug. Again, I just went on a second little tangent and I have not actually started making my breakfast. So I will check in with you when it's advent calendar time. So I am back from my wax. I finished uploading yesterday's vlog and I started watching, and just like that, the Sex and the City reboot. I am 13 minutes in and here are my reactions so far. Kristen Clark, is that the actress's name? Who replaced Charlotte. I feel like she's rusty. Her delivery feels very forced and stilted right now. So I hope she kind of sinks into it a little bit more. I probably won't be able to watch the second episode until later tonight, but I don't know. It just, yeah, it seems stiff. Like she's being like, well, I'm Charlotte and this is what Charlotte would do and say, and this is how Charlotte would say it. But it just seems very like, like it doesn't feel lived in. And that makes sense because she hasn't been living it for however, what, 20 years? I don't remember, 15 years? Yeah, so that makes sense. That makes sense. But it's, of all the, of the three women, she's the one I'm noticing it more. Cynthia Nixon's doing well. Like, I believe that she's Miranda this many years later. It feels, like, real to me. And then Sarah Jessica Parker, like, she's being Carrie. She just... it just feels the most natural, I think, with her. And yeah, they've got to fit in some exposition, like, oh yes, we are in the world of the lockdown. Oh, remember when it used to be illegal to be less than 6 feet away from people? Anyway, so they're working hard to establish the world that they're living in. But I don't know, like, I feel like they're doing well with setting up the world, even though it does feel kind of forced in some ways, it's paying off, I think. I see the work. It's very like they're showing their work, but I believe it. It's worse when they're like doing all this work and I'm like, and I still don't believe it. I don't know if I'm making sense. I find that I'm more critical. I consume TV shows more critically than I used to. And it's probably because I've been trying to watch more and different TV shows lately and I had given up on the Gossip Girl reboot. I think I watched maybe first four episodes, maybe more. I don't know, but I had to give up because it just, it was too, you know? The acting was atrocious, honestly. That's really critical. Probably wasn't atrocious, but it was not good. It was cringy. It was very cringy. And it might be the writing too, being just, it was very much like, we're Gen Zers in 2021, and this is how Gen Zers talk, and we're also rich, and so this is what we're doing. Anyway, but 13 minutes into the Sex and the City reboot, I feel it. It's real. This is happening. This feels lived in. And it's the same actors, so that helps. Also, if they had done a Gossip Girl reboot and done, like, all of the people from Gossip Girl that many years later, maybe I would have believed it more. Although by the time I watched Gossip Girl all the way through for the third time, I was hate watching it. And I told Tyler, please, if you ever hear me talking about wanting to watch Gossip Girl again, don't let me do it. Don't let me do it. I can't. Because by the time I watched it that last time, I'm like, I hate this. I hate this. Why am I still watching this? So anyway, I get it. I get why they didn't bring back the other people, because maybe they wanted them to keep their happy endings. I don't know. But I like this. I like that they're doing Sex and the City. They're bringing it back. They're going to be more aware and less problematic about things, but hopefully not too aware. You know, I don't want them to be like too careful with what they say, because that's not real either. Like, people in 2021 still say problematic things and make mistakes. So I don't want it to be like too pristine. And that's not Sex and the City. And I'm not even gonna talk about Samantha not even being in the show. That's fine. But what I will say is, so far, and spoilers, I guess, for the first 13 minutes of the show, but it seems like Harry and Charlotte are still together, and they were my favorite couple. So I'm really glad that they seem like they're still together. And Big and Carrie seem like they're still together, so kind of happy about that. But, you know, haven't seen Steve yet, but I don't think they're, I think I saw something in an article that they're not together anymore, but that he will be in the show. So anyway, yeah, that was a weird way of saying anyway. Very cool to see the kids grown up. I'm excited to see Brady all grown up. That was a very funny breakfast conversation. I won't say what the breakfast conversation was here on the vlog, but I believe it. That helped to build the world, like, yes. But I also kind of wish Samantha would have been there to be a part of that conversation. Although part of me also knows what she would say and how that conversation would go. And maybe that'd be kind of gross. So anyway. All right. So I am going to just keep watching this. I'm trying to kind of plan out the rest of my late morning, early afternoon. I technically don't have to be at my internship until 1 o'clock, but I thought I should probably get there a little bit early. I have a phone call I want to make, and then I just kind of want to feel sort of settled, because once 1 o'clock hits, it's like I've got something at 1, 2, 3, 4, and I go home. There's not going to be a moment. And the other thing is, that means I need to eat, even though I'm not feeling particularly hungry right now. The eggs were really filling, which is why I opted for them. But I think I need to honor my practical hunger, because I know that I will probably get starving by like 1 something, and I won't be able to have the opportunity to eat until after 5 o'clock. So yeah, I should probably eat. I don't want to. I'm not hungry. Maybe I'll have something small. Okay, and while I have you, let me do my advent calendars. I feel all over the place. My goodness. I'm very excited for my wax lady. I'm very, very excited for her. She is getting married So we were talking all about her wedding plans, and it's just, it's super exciting. I love it. All right. We'll do Mickey with the Christmas tree. Boom. Looking good, looking good. Move over my Santa. This show, so Sex and the City, reminds me of my grandma Pam, because as weird as it sounds, she's the one who introduced me to Sex and the City. I don't think I've ever said that out loud. I've always known, but like, I don't think I ever said that out loud. That is very funny. Yes, my grandma Pam is the one who introduced me to Sex and the City. She had them on DVD, and she just loved Carrie. She loved Carrie. And I get it. I think that if she could have gone back and lived her life in a slightly different way, or like if she had different opportunities, I think she would have wanted to be like Carrie. I don't know. She identified with Carrie. It was so cute. I think I got her like a Sex and the City board game at one point, and we all played it on a New Year's Eve together while drinking cocktails and like, oh my God. Anyway, so I'm watching this and I'm thinking of her and wondering if she has the opportunity to watch this. I don't know. So she and her husband, my grandpa, live in an assisted living center. That's really hard to say. And they have a TV and everything, but I don't know if they have like an HBO Max subscription or like someone to help them put it on or whatever, but I don't know. I'll ask her when I see her, but they're in the memory unit. So, if you know what that means, and you know what that means. If you don't, I'm not really going to get into it. It's kind of hard for me to talk about, but I'm just thinking of her. And of course, doing that little calendar always makes me think of her. All right, so today is a day where I do both of my chocolate advent calendars. So I am going to, my arm is starting to hurt. My arm is, it's starting to hurt from the booster. It just feels like lead. And then anyway, okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So day 5 for this one. This, ooh, dark ganache heart. I'm all for that. Yeah. Yeah. All right, so we're on day 9, so. Ooh, it's a big one. Oh, it's a big bear. But it feels light. I think it's hollow. Hollow bear. Hollow. Hollow. Hollow bear. I'm so weird. I'm so weird. Another little pile of laundry to put away, but I don't feel like doing it right now. You can't tell me what to do. You're not my mom. I don't feel like doing it right now, and I'm not going to. I want to relax. I want to keep watching Sex and the City. It feels weird to call it something else. To keep watching it just like that. AJLT. AJLT. Adjlut. AJLT? JLT, just like that. Sex and the City. I'm going down rabbit holes. Oh my God. This is exactly what I hoped would happen. I am secondhand embarrassed for a character on a TV show. Miranda! Oh, this is perfect. This is, remember how I said, I really hope they don't get too politically correct and like try to be like, you know, this. So Miranda is going to school for a master's, and she's digging herself into a hole with a professor, and is getting herself into some trouble. And it's, I keep going. Ah, yes, okay, I'm enjoying this. They're doing this well. And what I mean is, like, they're getting into trouble. Like, they're getting into hot water. And it's funny, but it's having an awareness of, like, the culture that we're in, but doing it really well. Like, it's entertaining, and she's also, like, it's showing, I'm learning all this stuff, and I'm trying to implement all these things that I've learned, but I'm making it worse at the same time. You guys, okay. 17 minutes in, I am having a good time. I might recommend this. We'll see. Yeah, you got the love I need to see me through. What? Okay. It's fine. I see why you had to do what you did. But that's not cool. It's not cool. All right, if you know, you know. All right, I gotta go. I gotta, like, pull myself together. I'm very emotional now. It's fine. I mean, it's, you see it coming. So I thought, well, it's gonna be this or this. And it was this. So, all right. I'm watching episode 2. Oh my God. Wow. That was good. 16 minutes and 29 seconds into episode 2. That was good. It's 8:52. I've just been watching Gilmore Girls, and I did about an hour of work from home. Did I say I shouldn't work? Did I say that this morning? That I should not work? That I should relax? I think I did. I might have said it last night. I don't know. Anyway, I did do a little bit of work, but it was fine. I'm glad I did, because the sooner I do work like that, the easier it is, honestly. So that was fine. That was good. So yeah, just watching some Gilmore Girls. I am genuinely looking forward to the next episode of And Just Like That. I hate that title. I really hate that title. The Sex and the City reboot. I'm looking forward to that next week. But yeah, I pulled out my camera because I'm gonna close out the vlog here. I actually feel like today's got a lot of footage to sift through, and I need to figure out when I'm going to edit it, because I don't feel like editing it tonight. You know what I could do, though, is at least import the footage tonight. And it's one less thing to do tomorrow. I can get up early and edit and upload tomorrow. But yeah, tomorrow I'm going to my practicum site early because I've got minimum 6 hours of paperwork to do, but probably more than 6 hours. And I'm giving myself about 5 hours to do it, knowing that I won't be able to get it all done. But yeah. Heading there, planning to be there at 11 o'clock. I normally get there at 2 o'clock on Fridays, but I feel like if I get there at 11, it's gonna give me a huge chunk of uninterrupted time to just hole up and get this done. Yeah. Anyway, thanks for watching today. I feel fine after the booster, except my arm hurts. It hurts when I raise it that much. You can't even see. I'm barely raising it, but it hurts. It's sore. Thankfully, I'm a right side sleeper, unless Tyler's there and then it's really warm. The air is really warm, so I usually turn on the other side. But it's just me tonight, so I'll sleep on my right side. Anyway, yeah, I'm gonna go to bed. Thanks again for watching. I think I already said that. Thanks for watching, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.